Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, from through the faces crowd and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still, when strife we cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as you have come to offer this sacrifice to the Lord, as the Lord calls us to be fertile in our life, to become more and more Christ-centered in life, as Jesus says in the parable how the seeds fell in the good soil and how it produced harvest of good life. In the same way, our Christian life must be something good, and we need to give something good to others by our way of life. And let us ask God's grace in our life to be honest to our Christian life and fulfill the commandments of God in our day-to-day living. Let us call to mind our sins, ask pardon for our failures and shortcomings in our life. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, your Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from Prophet Jeremiah. Return, O faithless children, declares the Lord, for I am your master. I will take you, one from a city and two from a family, and I will bring you to Zion. And I will give you shepherds after my own heart, who will feed you with knowledge and understanding. And when you have multiplied and been fruitful in the land, in those days, declares the Lord, they shall no more say, the ark of the covenant of the Lord. It shall not come to mind or be remembered or missed. It shall not be made again. At that time, Jerusalem shall be called the throne of the Lord, and all nations shall gather to it, to the presence of the Lord in Jerusalem, and they shall no more stubbornly follow their own evil heart. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord will keep us as a shepherd keeps his flock. The Lord will keep us as a shepherd keeps his flock. Hear the word of the Lord, O nations, and declare it in the coastlands of far away. Say, he who scattered Israel will gather him and will keep him as a shepherd keeps his flock. The Lord will keep us as a shepherd keeps his flock. The Lord has ransomed Jacob and has redeemed him from the hands too strong for him. They shall come and sing aloud on the heights of Zion, and they shall be radiant over the goodness of the Lord. The Lord will keep us as a shepherd keeps his flock. Then shall the young woman rejoice in the dance, and the young men and the old shall be merry. I will turn their mourning into joy. I will comfort them and give them gladness for sorrow. The Lord will keep us as a shepherd keeps his flock. Kindly stand for the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are those who hear the word, hold it fast in honest and good heart, and bear fruit with patience.
The Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time Jesus said to his disciples, "Hear then the parable of the sower. When anyone hears the word of the kingdom, he does not understand it. The evil one comes and snatches away what has been sown in his heart. This is what was sown along the path. As for what was sown on the rocky ground, this is the one who has ears the word, and immediately receives it with joy, that he has no root in himself, but endures for a while. And when tribulation or persecution arises on account of the word, immediately he falls away. As for what was sown among thorns, this is the one who hears the word, but the cares of the world and the deceitfulness of riches choke the word, and it proves unfruitful. As for what was sown on good soil, this is the one who hears the word and understands it. He indeed bears fruit and yields in one case 100-fold, in another 60, and another 30. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, the parable of the sower, with these words, today's Gospel passage begins the interpretation of the famous parable. It is first of all made very clear that the seed represents the message about it, God's reign, His will, His commandments. The ground or soil represents the various types of members in the church, those who have heard the message of Christ, who know God's will, who are aware of His commandments and have accepted them in various degrees. But the acceptance, this faith is not always persevering. Today, let us ask ourselves, what kind of ground this message of God, especially His commandments, falls on in our own lives? Sometimes we may feel God's commandments are unreasonable, outmoded, old-fashioned, not for our enlightened age. It is then, the parable says, that the evil one approaches to us, steal away what was sown in our minds by God's word. Do we stick to God's word through thick and thin, in adversity as well as prosperity? Or are we like the rocky patches of ground? Do we joyfully leave it when easy and agreeable, but strike it when it means carrying the cross with Christ? As the Gospel says, when some setback or persecution involving the message occurs, he soon falters. Perhaps we keep God's precepts quite regularly, but when it comes to money and living in case of comfort, we lose our sights. The lure of money may choke out the message. We see sins of injustice as simply good business. We look at our ease and our comfortable living as absolute necessities of life, and so reason that we have very little to give to the support of the church, the missions, very little to give to the uplifting of the poor and oppressed. O Lord, let me not be barren, rocky, weed, filled ground, but good soil on which the seed of your word may yield a hundredfold. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, we, the children of God, we need to be more sensible in our personal life. What Jesus wants in our life, let us try to fulfill, and let us try to be sincere to our call as children of God and do what is best so that we are able to produce good deeds in our Christian life. That our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with our one voice we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy,
Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Philip Neri our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be choirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the Living God, by the will of the Father, and by the Holy Spirit, who brought life to the world, free me from all my sins and from every evil. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
In the body and blood of Christ, may be everlasting. The Lord, the gracious, the merciful, has made a memorial of his wonders. He gives food to those who fear him. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those who are imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.